Talk to the servant. This kind of sin is that the sin caused Sodom and Gomorrah to be burned. If people can experience that, especially people 50 and beyond, they did not know these things before. And many people are shocked when other countries are legalizing. And they're still asking questions. What is it? I know some of the time, because we don't read the Bible, you get half information. But if you go through the Bible, you get it very well. What is it? And what God saying about it. You see, we are reaching a certain level that God will be very, very angry to us, because we are already out of our way. Though we are praying, we are only praying for miracles, but we are not praying that we can able to honor God's principles. Even us who have God as called, our assignment was be diverted. We are no longer warning people, we are only looking after material. I know why, because some of the message, if you teach them, the member will run away, because some of the member, they aren't to eat. Or other, they cannot come because they know, I mean, I want to remain in this kind of situation. You have heard even some statement here when a young lady, beautiful young lady or 25 years old, who really say, I mean, she's not been feeling shy to tell you that I want to remain in this kind of situation. I don't want to come out at all. And that we are going to learn that is not how I was talking. That was spirit talking through her. And God, she talking to me after giving that message, she said, I want you to go deep down, that people must know it, that themselves might decide if they want to stay on it or they want to come out and repent. This is the job Lord tried to do and his uncle Abraham in the land of Gomorrah, Sodom and Gomorrah. But people decided to do what they wanted to do. The same way today, people have decided what they want to do. That you see, even the devil said it here, they are so much in the hurry to capture everyone that before Christ came, he found no one. Exactly what happened in Sodom and Gomorrah. God found Noah. It started like this. God found Noah that God destroyed. But God, when God brings a certain message like this, God has given attention about that kind of matters. I know there are many ways it happened. Sometimes I'll leave my wife early in the morning, though it's cold, but I'll rush to my office to hear from God sometime that I can get the full message in action before God. When I said on Sunday that God made a man have a stick and a woman have a hole, everybody was laughing at me. They think I was saying something that is funny or new. He made this for a purpose. He made it for a purpose and a great purpose that made you to be sitting here. There's no human being came from the tree. Every human being in this earth, regardless how you are, you come from that exercise. Signed by God himself and approved. But because us have gone to school, we want to be beyond God. We want to change the nature. This is changing the nature. Because this kind of sin is unnatural. You know that? It's unnatural. God did not create it. He did not. Those who read the Bible will tell you. God did not create it. But where do you find it? And it is giving us a big challenge. Some of the challenges that we are going through there, we do not know where it's coming from. And most of the time, we point people finger. Look, like what my sister was doing, even I said it on Sunday. When you see a woman who does not want to sleep with the husband, you must know she satisfies herself in masturbation. Because she's a human being. And this kind of sin is not physically, it's spiritually. There's no other power when you involve yourself in that kind of life that can take you out. You cannot stop. You can stop drinking. You can stop womanizing. You can stop do all other things, habit. But for that one, he need a high authority that can able to handle it and help you to come out of that kind of bondage. Let's go quick to the book of Genesis chapter 19. Also, everybody have a Bible. Genesis chapter 19. Genesis chapter 19. Are you there? I start verse 1. The two angels arrive at Sodom in the evening, and the Lord was sitting in the gateway of the city. When he saw them, he got up to meet them and bowed down with his face to the ground. My Lord, he said, please turn aside your servant's house. You can wash your feet and spend the night, and then go on your way early in the morning. The angel said, no. They answered, we will spend the night in the square. Though that's your outside. But he, Lot, insisted strongly that they did go with him and enter his house. He prepared a meal for them, baking bread without yeast, and they ate. Before they had gone to bed, all the men from every part of the city of Sodom, both young and old, surrounded the house of Lot. They called to Lot, where the men who came to you tonight? Bring them out to us so that we can have sex with them. Lot went outside to meet them and shut the door behind him. And he said, no friend, no my friends. He's talking to the man that was standing outside. Don't do this wicked thing. Look, I have two beautiful daughters who have never slept with a man. Let me bring them out to you and you can do whatever you like with them. But don't do anything to those men, for they've come under the protection of my roof. They said to Lot, get out of our way. They replied, this fellow came here as a foreigner, and now he wants to play the judge. We will treat you worse than them. They kept bringing pressure on Lot and moved forward to break the door. But the men inside reached out, because those men, the angels, reached out and pulled Lot back into the house and shut the door. Then they struck the men from way at the door for the house, young and old, with blindness, so that they could not find the door. The two men said to Lot, do you have anyone else here? Son-in-law, sons and or daughters, or anyone else in the city who belong to you? Get them out of here, because we are going to destroy this place. The outcry to the Lord against its people is so great that he sent us to destroy it. So Lot went out and spoke to his son-in-law who were pledged to marry his daughters. He said, hurry and get out of this place, because the Lord is about to destroy the city. But his son-in-law thought he was joking. With the coming of the dawn, the angel urged Lot, saying, hurry, take your wife and your two daughters who were here, or you will be swept away when the city is punished. When he hesitated, the man grasped his hand and the hand of his wife and his two daughters, and lead them safely out of the city, for the Lord was merciful to them. As soon as he has brought them out, one of them said, flee from your life. Don't look back and don't stop anywhere in the plain, through to the mountain, or you'll be swept away. But Lot said to them, no, my Lord, please, your servant has found favor in your eyes, and you have shown great kindness to me in sparing my life, but can't flee to the mountain. The disaster will overtake me, and I will die. Look here, is a town near enough to run to, and is small. Let me flee to it. It is very small, is it? Then my life will be spared. He said to him, very well, I will grant this request too. I will do not overthrow the town you speak of, but flew there quickly because I cannot do anything until you reach it. That is why the town was called Soar. But the time Lot reached Soar, the sun has risen over the land. Then the Lord rained down burning sulfur of Sodom and Gomorrah from the Lord out of the heaven, that withdrawn those cities and the entire plain, destroying all those living in the city and all the vegetation of the land. But Lot's wife looked back, and she became a pillar of salt. Early in the morning, Abram got up and returned to the place where he stood before the Lord. He looked down toward Sodom and Gomorrah, toward all the land of the plain, and he saw dense smoke rising from the land like smoke from a furnace. So when God destroyed the city of the plain, he remembered Abram, and he brought Lot out of the catastrophe that overthrew the city where Lot as lived. Hallelujah. This is the story of Sodom and Gomorrah. You heard the story very well, that what happened because men did not want to sleep with women now. He was man to man. And when they saw that answer man, angel came, they say, this is a good thing to have it. They followed them to Lot's house. And they made sure to bring a fight with Lot that they can have those men. By God's grace, because those men, they're angel, and they did not know what the mission those angels came. And that made God to be very angry immediately, because he saw what people did to his angel that he sent in the land of Sodom and Gomorrah. Any question? You see, those are the first some city that was building the world. But people turned against God. And God could not bear God. I mean, what people did is a contrary to what God created. You see, when God know that Adam cannot do it alone, that he made to create Eve. Eve was the same like Adam, but what he made, he changed the sex. And the same way, as they met, they become one. But people, along the way, changed God's plan. And God was very angry about it, that Sodom and Gomorrah would be destroyed. And as us will continue to live the same way, like people of Sodom and Gomorrah, what do you think we are expecting from God? Is it blessings? Is it blessings? And believe me, the same God that was there that time is the same God that is today. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? That is the same God. It is the same God. Though God sent his son Jesus for his mercy, but believe me, that kind of sin, that is sin against the Holy Spirit. Because what we are doing contrary to what God had designed. They are teaching God another way. Are you getting there? You are teaching God another way. Though that shows God could not create very well. You have a good way to teach him how you could do it. You see, when we cannot come out, say exact what we are facing today, we are not going to come out of bondage, and God will never forgive us. Even some of us who are talking this, it's only by grace. Because we know the whole world is in trouble. It's not only, as we said, we are talking about man to man. But as God was revealing to me, he explained to me another way. He said to me, even when people are doing the way anal or oral with a member of the same or a member of opposite sex, is still abomination. Even when people are still doing it with the same sex, is still an abomination. It's not ending oral. God did not make it to do it oral. God did not make it to do in anal. God made it in a wonderful position. A stick and a hole must meet and they create another atmosphere. He did it by a purpose. When we go further, there's a word they call bestiality. Bestiality, we have some women and men who like to sleep with animals. The men and women, they don't need a human being. They only need an animal. Any animal. Can be a goat, can be a dog, can be a cat, I don't know. Any animal that they will like. Even men and women, they do so. All this, God did not create it. God is very angry with this kind of behavior. This is exact that is written against the Holy Spirit. That kind of sin cannot be forgiven. Is there any other sin? Even when you insult Jesus, you can be forgiven. But this kind of behavior, you cannot be forgiven unless you repent early. Let's go to the book of Leviticus. We did not write this book but it's the Bible. Leviticus chapter 20. I start reading verse 15. Are you there, verse 15? God commands, if a man has a sexual relationship with any animal, he must be put to death, and you must kill the animal. If a woman approach any animal to have sex relationship with him, kill both the woman and the animal. They must be put to death. Their blood will be their own head. It's not in your Bible. It's not in your Bible. Any question? Any question? This, in general, they call it sodomy. You see, we don't understand how God operates. And we do not understand why God made sex. But those understand the Bible, understand he made it for a great purpose. And he made it for a great reason. And he made it until a certain age or a certain point that might have it. That the name of marriage came. Can you hear me? That the name of marriage came. Because a man cannot do it alone, and a woman cannot do it alone. That he need a partner. Even people who read the Bible in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, you have heard they explain it very well, that a man does have no authority on his own body, even a woman so. That you see, every understanding couple, man and woman, before they fast, they must ask a partner if he's ready to fast. A woman must ask a permission to the husband. Can I fast? And the husband must ask a permission to the wife. Can I fast? That don't bring confusion. When we cannot able underline things like this, we can come here and lay out our hand with our hand dirty. There's no way God will hear our prayer. Hello? Are you together tonight? Are you together tonight? When our hand is dirty, there's no way God can hear our prayer. All this kind of sin is a sin against. It becomes a. That makes God very angry. This is the way Sodom and Gomorrah was be destroyed. But now, as we've adopted the same behavior, where we're going, when we've reached this level, even define God's house, we're in big trouble. We're in big trouble. Where are we going? And why are we gathering here when we know that we cannot be forgiven? There's no any other person can change our environment. You see, Sodom and Gomorrah. Abraham was praying if God can find even one person in Sodom and Gomorrah. They could not find anyone until God destroyed. Look, even Lot, who was a prayerful man, he could not know the heart of the wife. Thank God for the life of Lot, Because if could be you, when your wife has break the law, you could say, ah, you also could turn behind. But Lord was focusing. The wife remained and Lord went forward. Salvation is individual. Salvation is a individual. Don't pray because of a friend is praying. Don't pray because your wife is praying. Pray for yourself. Pray for your. It happened to Lot. I don't know how many. I mean, they have big daughters. Look at Lot. To prevent God, Lord, he wanted to sacrifice his two daughters who never been touched by a man. Who can do so? Who can do so? And he did not know how many men was outside there, but he said, no, if you want to kill my daughter, kill them, take them, than to touch these people. How many people can do it to defend God? Hello? The same way we are blowing the trumpet like this, people still saying fire, fire churches. We are blowing the trumpet, but people see bakwere kwere. Time is coming. Tough time is coming. Tough time is coming. If really we cannot able to embrace God, if really we cannot go to our knees, like what the king of Nineveh did, they bow down and ask God forgiveness to rescue the city of Nineveh. We need a total repentance. Because you are not doing it. Your children are doing it. Your brother are doing it. Your sister are doing it. Your nephew, whatever, they are doing it. This kind of case, it goes generation after generation because of against the Holy Spirit. If you want it, we need to repent. There's something wrong somewhere. We need to pray. We need to pray. Any question before pray? Write it down. Genesis chapter 19. Go and read it on your own understanding. Right now, Leviticus chapter 20 and read it on your own understanding and understand all these things you are doing. Other annoying. Because no one told us. But today, by God's grace, we've heard about it. You don't need to go there and point people finger. Because when you point a finger, you know when I'm doing like this, the big finger coming back to me. Can you hear me? The big finger coming back to me. You don't need to point anybody's finger. Check your own life. Check your own hair. You know, the thief that are very, very stubborn. When you see somebody beating a thief hard, you must know he's also a thief. Because you do not know. When you see somebody is beating a thief very hard, you must know he's also a thief. that I said, when I do this, you must know that the big finger coming back to me. No one to point finger. You know yourself. You know yourself. You know yourself. What in this kind of warning is a grace. Only what we need to do to thank the Lord and ask for forgiveness. Because if they could find even one person in Sodom and Gomorrah who was righteousness, who can ask forgiveness on behalf of the whole city, God could not able to destroy the city. God could not destroy the city. But they found Noah. Now, as us hearing this kind of revelation, God needs only one person who is righteousness here in our country, or here in our region, or in this world, to stand on behalf of all other people, and God can hear our prayer, and our life will change. Us were only spokesmen who only come here and warn. We're only ringing the bell. Our work is to ring the bell. But I'm not the master. I only be sent by the master. I'm only ringing the bell. Don't stone me. Don't stone me. I'm not the one. I'm only here sent by for warning. You see, some of the message God gives us is the message that is very difficult to speak and when you are in a natural way. Only you wear his coat. You can say anything. I don't care who is there. I only deliver because what God told me to say. And after that, I can go sleep peaceful because I delivered the message. Like I said before, no one to point finger. If you see a thief be beaten very hard, you must know that one also is a thief. We speak in parable. Because we say, I don't do this, but what about this one? We want to pray. This message is not for other people's message. This is a personal message. You don't need to point other people's finger. Look at your own life. Can you hear me? Look at your own life. Maybe you never done it before, but one day you do it. Or you have done it before you stopped. There is no way you can point people's finger. Look at your own life. Lot was very smart. Though he saw his wife remain behind, he said, he moved forward. We want to pray. I know by God's grace I've delivered this message. Many of them are going to surrender because they need God's mercy. Because other people, they don't know. They don't know the consequence. They don't know what happened. They find themselves already in. But by God's grace, the mercy of God is going to fall upon us. We want to pray tonight. In this kind of message, it's not necessary to point the people finger or prophesy into the people. All of us will fall short of a glory. We need to repent. We need to read. When a message does not touch you, you are not yet ready to repent. Can you hear me? When a message does not touch you, you are not yet ready to. But when you find that I'm talking about you, I'm not talking about you. You must know it's Jesus talking about you. Come out before you be Sodom and Gomorrah. This time, God is not destroying the city. God is destroying you personally. Hallelujah. Today, the punishment is not general. No, the punishment now is individual. You yourself. But if you find a righteous man, he can able to cover everyone. We want to pray. If you see this kind of message has affected you tonight, you must know, you must do something about it as soon as possible before it becomes too late. You see, Lot went even further to warn his in-laws, but they could not take it serious. The same way, this kind of message is not going to come tomorrow again. It's going to come for some years after, if God wants it again. But you have heard it, get advantage for it before it becomes too late. We want to pray. Today, we are not going to talk to anyone. Today, all of us must prophesy ourselves in our own life.
Come on.